Now, we have one more shape, and that is the, here's the F to the D minor to the F shape, or the L shape. Take it down, use your ears for the octave. Use your ears, man. You don't have to use the fret, just use your ears. The object here is to get used to using our third eye. We don't even have to look at the neck no more. Just everything's going to be positioned in space by star graphs. Just connect the dots in space in your mind. And your hand will automatically go to it. If you train your ear too. Your inner ear, your third eye ear, and your outer, and your inner eye, your third eye. And your senses. You got five outer senses, you got five inner senses. You actually got six, and more than that. There's unlabeled senses too. So here's the major right here. First string bass, this would be the L shape. Here's the A shape, second string bass. Here's the P shape, third string bass. Notice we had a P shape also in the F bass, somewhere in there. There it is right there. That would be the same as this. Just the same thing, just a different area on the fretboard, which brings us more toward the different timbre. The strings are softer and they're louder and they're bigger. Not necessarily louder, but they're just thicker and fuller. Full of resonance, full of reverb. Up here they're full of banjo timbre, because you're using the thinner strings. Then we got the C shape on the four string bass. Get into the taps. Where are the majors for the taps? As soon as I studied that one, it's on my list.